As I walk across the middle of the street in downtown, wherever the I am, we're in Florida. We're gonna go check out some liquor stores. We found some cool things. We're looking for some stuff. We're looking for maybe a new riff or that Chris Stapleton Buffalo Trace bottle that supposedly dropped here. So let's hope we can get some bottles this afternoon and make this long trip worth it. Check out this store. Wow. So this is really cool. They got a couple different things that I've not seen before. 2024 New Year blend from Barrel, $79.99. I heard the Bourbon Judge again. That's who I get a lot of my recommendations on tastings from. Really enjoyed that. And then as well as this, look at that. All right, so this is 50% 10-year Widow Jane for $100. I don't know about you, but I've never had this gold label bronze bottle, the anniversary edition. Is this relatively old or is it this year's? Oh, it is old, 2022. How about that? That's still sitting on the shelf. I wonder what that's all about. I mean, I'd love a 100 proof Widow Jane product. That seems really interesting. And then over here, we have some of the local stuff, the local St. Augustine distillery. Maybe heading to St. Augustine. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Gunner's Weeded, as well as this. But the best part about this store, and the thing that a lot of people see as soon as they walk in this door, you're greeted with stacks on stacks on stacks on stacks.
Cases on cases on cases on cases on cases on cases on.
A Four Roses single barrel, barrel strength, 9-year, 4-month, 20% rye, OESQ, and $109, which is pretty much the going rate for these from what I've heard online. But I've thankfully found some, so I'll pass on these, but I will try it just to see what it's all about. And also, we have the Yellowstone sitting pretty at 119 freaking proof. So there's a lot of really cool bottles here. They have some really nice single barrel store picks, so I'm excited to see some more of those. They even have a Peerless single barrel at 106 proof at $109. And then Nulu, don't get me excited about a Nulu now, because I love Nulu stuff, even though it is MGP or whatever they call it nowadays, but I love a good Nulu bottle because we can't get these in South Carolina. As well as a weeded bourbon, I Am Golden God. Oh, it's got a tater sticker on it. Surprised? $80 for a weeded. What's the age statement on here? Is there an age statement sticker? Nope, not quite. So the manager was telling me that most people come in asking for Blantons and then they point them in this direction. $64.99 for a Wathen single barrel that they picked. We're gonna try it here in just a minute. We'll see if it really stands up to the Blanton's tribute. I love this. I love the fact that they can do this here. Literally ask for a sample. You want to try it? Here you go. So what is this? Straight bourbon, the Riverside pick. Oh, so this is the team pick right here. Very nice. $59 for an old elk pick. They also have an old soul here. 117 proof old soul pick for $79.99. How about that? That's not bad. God, that's a lot of freaking Four Roses. Ooh, these are some good prices on these. I don't know if y'all know, but this is a really good bottle to grab. Highly recommend that one. Still looking for a really good Fiddler single barrel pick from a store that knows what they're doing. I haven't seen one that's I've really tried that's super good since the Turtle Creek video. So hoping to find one today, maybe. A little New England Barrel Company, 119 proof, 3.5 year. Interesting. What do you imagine that has some interesting flavor notes if it's aged up there in New Hampshire? Oh boy, what is this? Cask strength selected, Jacksonville, Florida by Chris Corbett. What is this proof? Is that 58? Oh dude, that's pretty spicy right there. Mmm, I like that. What else they got hiding over here? Lacking. I'm looking for maybe a bottle of New Riff. It's got to be like pretty labor intensive to have every single employee mark each bottle every single time. Finally, a freaking benchmark foolproof for $22? Yeah, I don't think I'm ever going to find that cheaper. Even the single barrel is more than the foolproof, and I think the foolproof is much better. By Buffalo Trace. Yep, $22. That's... And everybody's like, oh, that's not 22, that's 23. Okay, if you're counting pennies, sure, let's do it. But great price, I'm gonna grab this. Now we're gonna try this new riff. Aroma, walnut, wildflowers, flavor, caramel, strong rye, finished black pepper. Sitting at 105 proof. And y'all are completely sold out of this? Ah, that's tough. That's a good bottle. That's a good single barrel. I'm not too interested in Irish whiskey quite yet. Yeah, not... You gonna make me try the rum? Okay. Single cask rum Barbados. Sitting at a 96. Oh my god, no, wait. That's almost 120 proof rum. Ooh. Oh, this is literally so sweet on the nose. Oh my gosh.
Doesn't it kind of
open up like that? It opens up right at the end. That is crazy.
Yeah.
You're at 89 a bottle now?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's a, if I'm going to turn a bourbon drinker onto something, it's usually that.
Yeah, that's the one. That's so good. Last Chance Sail Wreck. Boondocks finished in port barrels by Bardstown. 8-year-old straight bourbon whiskey for $49. An 8-year-old? Master distiller. 90 proof. I mean, how bad can that be? Right? I mean, it can't be that bad. Hold on. We're going to do some research on this. Yep. We're going to pass on this. We're just going to pass on that. Yep. Check this out. New Riff Malted Rye Whiskey, aged 6 years, 100 proof. I've been looking for a new riff, but I don't know if this is like the one to get. Distilled in fall of 2017. Very cool. And then they got this whole shelf of allocated stuff, as well as their entire store pick section. And you see it right there. Yeah, you see it. All right, so let's check this out. They got the Remus, but then you see it. Do you see it? You see it? So $500 for the Generations Wild Turkey. Yes. And then $59.99 for the 1792 Bottle and Bond. As well as they got the Pack 9 and obviously the Widow Janes that are very frequent down here. See those quite often. Look at these. The toasted, all these great things. As well as, which one is that? B522. All right, no problem. Yeah, so they got a couple really good bottles hidden back here. Most of these are for a pretty reasonable price, I'd say. I don't know if I'm gonna regret not getting this or not, but let's check out the other stuff. They have some store picks here. This is Shores Port Finish for $90, as well as the Yellowstone, 102 proof. So we're seeing different proof points around town. That's pretty cool. As well as the Whistle Pig and the Remus. I've never had a Remus from them. 21% rye mash bill. It's a decent rye mash. I like that. All right. Wow, look at this price on this Long Branch. $29.99 for Long Branch. 8-year wild turkey bottle. $79.99 for the Kentucky Spirit. That's about regular price. This is the one that kind of got me interested. Yeah, look at that freaking deal right there. $26 for one of the best 10-year whiskeys on the market, made by Wild Turkey. I'm gonna get one of these, and I'm probably going to tater out a little bit, snag one or two of these, because $29.99 is a good price for a Buffalo Trace 750 milliliter. So they got these bundled deals right here. So essentially, you buy both of these at retail, and you gotta buy these two to get the cigar blend, these to get the Michter's 10-year rye, which those are all good bottles, so if that interests anybody, they're here, and they say that it rotates all the time on which bundle deals are where. Not entirely sure why these are looped together, but you got a Jim Beam product, an MGP product, and then a High West product, all bundled together for one, which I think is a great deal. They also got the St. Augustine Distillery single barrel Florida straight bourbon whiskey, collaboration with a local bourbon club. I wonder if it's worth the price. I wonder if they got one open. Very true, yeah. They got this Chattanooga Cabernet finish, greater than 4 years. Oh, I heard this was really good too. I'm a big Chattanooga fan. If the price is right, I may snag one of these. Yeah.
No, with all the dust comes in from here. I dust these like all the time.
Yeah. Yeah. Is there do you know the price on this by chance? I hate to waste too much time.
$59.99.
Oh man, that's not for me today, unfortunately. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. Alright, we're gonna grab one of these. Buffalo Trace 5th, and then a 5th of Russell's 10. Can't have a better duo right here. I'm gonna use the Russell's to mix and the Buffalo to sip. Or either one, I don't care how I feel. Buffalo Trace sitting on the shelf, as well as the leaders, actually.
Could you see it?
Buffalo Trace sitting on the shelf.
Buffalo Trace sitting on the shelf.
Buffalo Trace sitting on the shelf.
For a reasonable price for two, I mean, you don't see it sitting on the shelf in South Carolina, so that's really nice to see. And then they even have the new Uncle Nearest single barrel that I picked up the other day. I don't know if it's the same single barrel or not, but these are really, really good. I thoroughly enjoyed the pour I had from this, much more than the Yellowstone I had.
We got all the Sagamores here, but I have not seen this bottle in bond before. This is really different. 5-year-old rye whiskey, bottled in bond.
Are these worth it? I don't know. They're kind of dusty, but a bottled in bond Sagamore has to be pretty good. They make great rye. So I may think about this one.
It's a little early in the day, but I might come back for that. They got a Peerless Double Oak here as well. Really good bottle. If you haven't had that yet, you should 100% pick these up. That's batch 10. Really good bottle.
Oh, we got a little old Overholt. These are starting to pick up the actual 10-year. Don't know if I'm going to find one of those today or not. Sometimes when you find dusty bottles like this, you hope you find a black cap sitting back here, but not the case, unfortunately. I've never seen this big of a bottle of Sazerac rye. It's absolutely insanely huge. Crazy. So they have their Elijah Craig private barrel here at 127 proof, and then the Maker's Mark Golden Ox with that stave profile on it. This is a really big bottle. This is $64. And then they also have their other store picks here. This one is finished in sherry casks for 9 months.
They got a little four gate up there. What is that? The rye whiskey. And then the Remus.
They got the Fourgate up here, the Barossa Creek, and then the Remus as well. I heard these are really good, finished in port casks. Fourgate does not make bad stuff.
Also got this Old School Foursquare 2010 single blended rum. Some other things I haven't really seen before, like that, whatever that Founders is. Founders Brewery?
I may be stupid, but I literally just looked at this. This is the 8-year I've been looking for.
I went up there and I asked him the price for this, and then I put this back on the shelf. And I just looked at this like I was
actually stupid, because this is the one I've been looking for. I've literally been looking for this since I saw it in a video, and everybody gave me for not buying it. So
this one's coming home with me. I can't believe there was another one back there too. Oh, dude, these are good bottles.
All right.
I guess you can like never really judge a book by its cover, because this store is
just kind of in a weird part of town where you wouldn't expect to see a whole lot of stuff. But I mean, I got a reasonable price on Buffalo in there, and even on the half gallon, it's really not a bad price.
Well, guys, we're wrapping up our time here in Florida. It is an interesting place to come and an even more interesting bourbon scene down here. I'll tell you what, Jacksonville did not disappoint, but it also had some crazy museum prices that I didn't even film. So all in all, I had a really good time. I picked up 3 bottles of Buffalo Trace for $25. I think I picked up one of them for $29 at a different store, but gotta share the love a little bit. And then I also had the opportunity and spoke with a gentleman at the ABC chain store, and he got me to get this local brand. I was all trying to get a local brand today. I got the 7-year rye whiskey made right here in Florida, so super excited to have this. And the pinnacle of today, which is not a crazy hype bottle, but it is a good bottle, and I'll showcase all of the ones that I got here. This is the overview of exactly kind of what I gathered today for the prices. That they're insane, great prices down here on certain items. But unfortunately, it's just the case of the bourbon world, and you got people that are willing to charge a little bit extra for certain allocated bottles. So the one that I'm really excited that I picked up today is this Sagamore 8-year. It has eluded me since I featured it in a video and had no clue what I was looking at. Now I finally have one, and now I can enjoy it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to check out the Discord. Got almost 700 people in there. And then check out the Patreon so you can help support travel videos like this. We're going to go to some more states this year, guys. Can't wait. Until next time, Bourbon Hunter out.